Guys, it's Chris from Defy the Ocean. I'm back with another reaction video. And today, we're listening to a bit more Eskimo Callboy. Why? Because I enjoyed Hypa Hypa so much. I thought, let's give them another listen. Let's see what else they have in their repertoire. So this was a suggestion by someone in the comments for the previous song. It's called Crystals. I know nothing about it. Maybe, actually, it was mentioned that this is a slightly more serious song, so not as tongue-in-cheek as Hypa Hypa, so I'm interested to hear what that sounds like from these guys, because, frankly, I really enjoyed Hypa Hypa. I thought, even when you take the kind of comedy of the song and the video aside, it was actually a really strong song with some really catchy sections. They had a lot of fun with the vocals, which were awesome and brutal, and the vocal melodies in the chorus were really catchy. So yeah, I really enjoyed it. So I'm keen to hear what these guys have to offer. So let's go with Crystals. Okay, so we're hearing that fusion of electronic and metal. Okay, so this is a different singer, right? This isn't the same singer that as we have in Hypa Hypa, if I understand correctly. Okay, this is a lot more straight up metal. We've still got some synth elements. It's interesting because what I'm hearing from this is actually, yeah, it's more straight up heavy rock metal, but in terms of like the riffs and stuff that I'm hearing, they're actually feeling a little less mature than the stuff that I heard on Hypa Hypa, which is quite interesting. Yeah, nothing much more to say than that. I mean, the lyrical content is a bit, it feels like it's almost taking itself too seriously, right? So, what were the lyrics? I woke up this morning, don't remember last night, or who's next to me, something like that, something to do with the drugs and the drink. Okay, yeah. Okay, you party hard. So what? You want a medal? Yeah, musically I'm not completely enjoying it, but I have to say that the production is very good. The aggressiveness and the just kind of how powerful the guitars are is really, really good, really well done. And it just kind of really adds to the brutality. The fact that they've got his vocal here in the chorus and it's really kind of soaring above those heavy guitars, but those guitars are still meaty and crunchy and just in your face, really good. This is nice with the lead guitar. I mean, that the sound is really powerful. That's a cool image. electronic section. Breakdown. Okay, what do I think of that? Overall, I thought it was a less interest. I mean, Hypa Hypa, because that's my only frame of reference right now. I actually really enjoyed Hypa Hypa because it was really interesting. Like, I didn't know where they were going to take me from section to section. And with this, I guess I was in a lot more familiar territory. I just kind of felt like the riffs themselves were not that interesting. And the structure was very traditional. Overall, I felt that the best section for me that worked the best was the ending, as the drum beat picked up into double time. I thought that was the most interesting part of the song, and maybe kind of went into almost like thrashy slash or kind of metalcore territory, and I thought that was interesting. But otherwise, I didn't find this song particularly inspiring. I think maybe the thing to talk about here is, in Hypa Hypa, I found that what they did with the synths was really adding to the song overall. So it was almost like, the riffs in Hypa Hypa might not have been like massively different to the kind of thing that we saw in this song, Crystals, but because they were complemented with synth in a way that was kind of overall created a different sonic picture, and that kind of fusion was doing something new and interesting. It was really fresh to the ears. With this, I was not getting that freshness, and I'm not actually sure, like, what year was this released? This was in 2015. Okay, that kind of makes sense, because it feels a lot more dated, really. And I think I can say with certainty that I prefer their new singer a lot more. It seems like they've really brought it together with Hypa Hypa, just in terms of, you know, whether or not that's reflective of everything that they're doing in their current kind of release strategy. It just feels like a lot more mature and put together and polished. Interesting to see what fans of the band think about where the band is now versus where they were when they released Crystals, because I can see in 2015 I might have actually been a lot more on board with this song than I am now, and I'd be keen to think or to hear from Eskimo Callboy fans to hear what they think of the band's progression, and whether it's something that they're on board with, or that they think they, you know, they might have sold out with Hypa Hypa or something like that. Keen to hear what your thoughts are on it, so let me know in the comments, please, and let's have a conversation, or maybe bring it to the Discord channel and we can have a proper chat. Other than that, that's my reaction, and I hope you enjoyed it. I was as honest as I possibly could be. As you know, that's always the case. So, like I said, if you enjoy it, like, subscribe, comment, join the Discord, and we'll take it offline. That's it for now. There'll be more reaction videos soon. Keep an eye out. Take it easy.